Do you understand Hindi? Do you understand complete Hindi? I want to speak just some words to you. Do you understand Hindi? No? So she will translate to you in Gujarati. You cannot find any country in India. There are so many states in India. Why? From north to south, east to west of India. There are many different kinds of places in India with different kinds of people that speak different language, not only one language. People who speak different language. You see, here, in Gujarati, somebody gave it. Another person gave it. So like Telugu, Tamil, Hindi, so many different languages, and the people, they have different culture, different way of walking, different way of living, different way of eating. The climate is also different. Here is so hot. But in Delhi it's super cold now, in Delhi. So India is a place of so much diversity of climate, language, costume, culture. But if you go to Himachal Pradesh, also North India, is like even snowing in December, January. So much snow there that time of the year. And here is so hot. Here is also cold sometimes. Yes, sometimes it's cold here. But generally here is more hot. I don't know when it's cold here, because when I came February is also hot, and now December, I mean November, December is also hot. So when it's cold here, I don't know. Maybe, yeah, it's like just during the morning and a little bit evening, then the climate changes. But here also does not rain so much, huh? Yeah, does not rain so much. Every two, three years it rains. So how the trees, they live? He said, no, but there's a system of the soil is also irrigated or something. So the nature rains itself. Even without rain, the nature somehow arranges. So people with different languages, different culture. But still, India is connected by only one thread. We are all connected by one thread. What is it, this thread? That we are all connected by the same thread. It's Rama and Krishna. Jaya. From south to north, west to east, everywhere in India, the flag of Bhagavan Ram and Krishna is established. This is the speciality. this old culture of the Puranas and the Vedic culture. India is such a pious land. In other place on earth, you cannot find a place like India. Here is a different, unique and unparalleled. Where Swayam Bhagavan Krishna and Ram, they appeared here. Great rishis and munis. Great personalities appeared in India. You cannot find this in anywhere else in the earth, on the earth, except for India. People are all connected by this beautiful love and affection. In other countries, you cannot find this. Why am I saying this? I also have gone to many places, many countries. Maybe 4 or 50 different countries I've been to. 40 or 50 countries. And I saw they also have different climates in these places. But India is such a beautiful and sweet place. You cannot find this in any other place on earth. This is the spirituality land, Paramarthik Bhumi, the land of the spirituality, India. Everybody is connected by spirituality. The Western countries is full of atheism. And everybody is intoxicated in the enjoyment, sense enjoyment. But in India, until nowadays, people are hearing the katha of Rama and Krishna. Even in the TV, it's available, this katha of Rama and Krishna. Yeah, there are some demons here also. It's not that there are no demons in India, there are. The Shastra explains also, in the Gita, Bhagavan told, there are two kinds of people in this world, demons and demigods, or people with the godly nature and demoniac nature. There are two kinds of people with different kinds of nature in this world. Two kinds of nature in the people. One, those who have nature of demon, and Bhakta Bhav, nature of devotee. So always there is a quarrel or fight between the demigods and demons. Sometimes the demons, they conquer the Swarga kingdom, and then the demigods, they defeat the demons and again take back their kingdom. This is the rules of this world, tradition. This is always going on. Poor and rich, happiness and happiness, these antonyms, like health and disease, all these antonyms. So if there's a rich man, there's a poor man. If there's a poor man, there's a rich man. This is natural in this world. See, how many fingers we have in our hands? In one hand? 5. Are they all the fingers same? They are not same. One is thin, another is thick, one is dwarf. You see this thumb, it's so small, isn't it? You see, but who did these different fingers? God. If God had made all fingers same, we'll not be able to even write. If all fingers were the same size. So God is the creator. So, like amazing and wonderful, all this different diversity that God created. If we analyze the creation of God, we see how beautiful it is. And every part of the body is in a perfect place. Like, for example, eyes are here, and ears. Everything, each limb is in the specific and proper place. So in the Bible, there is a word. God created man after his own image. Image means just like his own photo.
God created man after his own image.
Just like himself. This is called
God
Bhagavan created many animals and birds, but he was not yet satisfied. Why? He saw that these animals, they wouldn't be able to deliver from this material world in their bodies. Cats, dogs, buffalo, cows, they will not do Bhagavad Bhajan. They will only do four things. Isn't it? Dog, cat, cow, buffalo. They are only doing four things. Which things? Eating?
Ahar.
Everybody eats or not? Who did not eat today? Raise your hand. Have we eaten? Have we eaten? You didn't eat anything today? Have to feed her. Didn't eat anything? Since morning? Oh, I eat.
So
everybody eats or not? A cow eats, dog eats, cat eats, everyone eats. Everyone also sleeps. At least you sleep like Kumbhakarna or not? You sleep, did you sleep or not? No? Didn't sleep during the night? Yes, I slept. And you? I slept. Everyone is afraid also. The biggest fear of everyone is the... Which fear you have? Fear from death. We are all afraid of dying. We are all afraid of dying. Isn't it? Why? We don't want to go from this world. Is that illusions of Maya? Externally you say, oh Maharaj, whenever you want, you take me. But when Jam Maharaj comes, Jam Maharaj, no, give me 3 days more. Like externally say, oh God, you can take me any moment. Oh death, you can come in any moment. But when death comes, you want more time to live. There was an old lady, she was very poor. So she used to collect dry wood in the forest and sell this dry wood. And she used to maintain her life like this, selling dry wood. She was very old, 70, 80 years old, feeling so much pain in her waist and back also pain. So she was collecting the wood and she made a bundle of woods, dry woods. So she was thinking in her mind, what can I do? Jam Maharaj is taking everyone, why he's not taking me? I'm already 80 years old. Then she said, hey Jam Maharaj, you are looking at everyone but not at me. Why? Then Jam Maharaj just came in front of her. Jam Maharaj said, hey old lady, come with me. Where? Let's go to Jamlok. The old lady started to cry. But what happened? You just called to me. Jam Maharaj told her, you have just called me to take you. I came. The old lady, very, very clever, she said, oh Jam Maharaj, listen to me. You know why I called you? Because I have this bundle of wood. It's very heavy. I wanted you to help me carry. Please put it on my head so that I can carry. So people will say in this world, they want to die. But actually no one wants to die. Everyone is afraid of death. Everyone. To speak is one thing, but actually to really want this in your life is another point. Also, like also get married and have babies. All, for all the jivas, it's the same.
So
the animals and human beings, they are same in this regard. So tell me, what is the difference then between animals and human beings? You tell me. Only one difference. One? Which one? The animals cannot chant holy names, do bhajan. They cannot. But we are human beings. We say very proud, we say, like proudly we say, we are human beings. Yeah, but the human beings, they can do bhajan of God, chant holy names. Animals, birds, insects, trees, they cannot do bhajan. But we as a human beings, we can do it. At least during the day we can chant the name of Ram. Simple name, direct. Ram. You can do it or not. You can chant the names of Bhagavan, Ram or Krishna. Okay, but at least the name of your own son you can take. What is the name of your son? Haku, Baku, Daku, Chaku. Daku means also thief, Chaku means knife, some crazy names without any meaning. So, what is your name that your father gave you?
Raj.
Raj. Raj. Okay, good. And yours? Jia. Better is Radha, Govinda, Krishna. These names are better than yours. At least during the day 10 times you'll call your son. Give the name of your son Krishna, Gopal, Govinda. Gopal, wake up, Gopal. Go to the job. Go to school, Gopal. Go to school. Gopal, Gopal. Gopal. Somehow, if anyone, even one time you chant the name of God, it's very good. So, the glories of holy names are described in the scriptures. There was one person who was a very simple person. He was very simple. He was a person from village, very simple. Very innocent man, simple. Without any duplicity in him. Once this person was going and then he came to a village. But some bad people were living in that village, some cheaters. But this man from the village was very simple, he didn't know people would like cheat him or anything. So when he came to that village, there were some people sitting in one place. And this, they were actually all thieves. They were thieves. They were muggers or thieves. But that man that had come from village, he didn't know that in this other village was full of thieves. So when he came, there was many people sitting down. So this group of people said, Narayan, Narayan, Narayan. Then this simple man thought, oh, people of this village are so nice, they are chanting the names of Narayana. They are chanting Narayana. But Narayana, actually, they meant, who is coming? Nara, Nara means human being, means a man came. Narayana, another meaning is this, like man, right, a human being. So that's why they were saying this. After some time, then the thieves, they were communicating to each other. So they ask, how is this person? So they are just speaking like this, Gopal, Gopal, Gopal. Gopal is the name of Krishna. But another meaning of Gopal is the shepherd. Not shepherd, sorry, the cowherd boy, cowherd. Very simple person. Cowherd boy, cowherd person, very simple. Okay, then the thieves communicating. Does he have money? Then one of the thieves told, Madhava, Madhava, Madhava. Madhava means names of God, yes. Another meaning, Ma means Lakshmi Devi. Someone who has a lot of money is called Madhava. Ma means Lakshmi. Dava means the Lord of Lakshmi. So someone who has a lot of money is also called Madhava. Okay, next he continued, and one of the thieves asked, okay, where is he keeping his money? Then somebody said, Damodar, Damodar. Another thief answered, Damodar. Dam means in his waist, like he's bound by the waist. Damodar, you know this money belt they put on the, or the, how do you say the funny pack? How do they call it in front? In English, I forgot the word. funny pack. Just see people use money here, they put money here. Pochette. Okay, so Damodar means he had the money actually on his belt or in his belly. And okay, what to do? Hari, Hari. Then the thief said, Hari means name of God, and also let's steal him. Let's steal his money. Some other person, okay, how are we going to steal him? Vasudev, Vasudev, Vasudev. Vasudev means names of Krishna, and also Vasudev means let's take the bamboo and let's beat him with a bamboo stick. So then the thieves, they beat him with the bamboo sticks and they took all his wealth. The thieves took all the money of the simple man and then they gathered in a cave in a hill and they were sharing the money between themselves. And then they were saying, oh, I chanted this name, I chanted Damodar, I chanted the name Hari. They were saying. Then suddenly a lightning fell there. When the lightning fell, you know, the lightning, they died from the lightning. They all died because of the lightning. After dying, the Jamadutas, the messengers of Jamaraj, brought all the thieves to Jamaluk, to the hell, or to be judged. And then Jamaraj asked Chitragupta, you know Chitragupta, like whatever we do, good things and bad things, who is writing everything that we do? Chitragupta, he is writing everything. Why his name is Chitragupta? Because hiddenly, he's taking pictures or filming us. Hiddenly. He's taking the hidden photos. That's why his name is Chitragupta. So he's taking your pictures. We call it CCTV or surveillance camera. You have also CCTV in your house. All this came from Jamaraj, actually, all this system of surveillance. So the cleric of Jamaraj, his name is Chitragupta. Chitra means photo, Gupta means hidden camera. And you say, oh no, I didn't do this. I did not do this wrong thing. You say, didn't do? Look, the proof is here. You were filmed. So Jam Maharaj asked his clerk, Chitragupta, hey, what did these thieves do? Jam Maharaj asked. Chitragupta told Maharaj, they were all thieves. They stole wealth of the person. Then they died because of a lightning fall. So we brought them here. Jam Maharaj told Chitragupta, look, please check if they did some pious or sin for activities. You know, after the death, you must go where? You have to go to Jam Maharaj. Where you have to go to? To Jam Maharaj. Everyone. Everyone must go to Jamaluk. You have to go to the court. The court will be judged. You will be judged. All things will be considered there. Whatever you say. Yes, Bhagavatam explains. The Jamadutas will take you, drag you by a rope in the neck, drag you, and then there will be judged. Did you do simple activities or pious deeds? It will be judged, then it will be taken to different places. Let's do it. Then Jam Maharaj. So Chitragupta told Jam Maharaj they were all thieves. They stole somebody's wealth. But how did they die? How did they give up their body? When they were chanting the holy names. Hearing this, Jam Maharaj said, okay, send them all to Vaikuntha. Why? Because once they chant the holy names, somehow they chant the holy names. So you have to go to? You don't need to go to Jamaluk. I'm not telling you to do bad things and chant holy names also. No. It's just an example. That anyhow, if at least once you chant the holy names of Lord, Sakrit means once. If you chant the holy names once, you'll be free from this material world and you go to the abode of the Lord. So everybody should chant.
Hello, Sitaram, Sitaram, Sitaram.